biology.
So very much welcome to this class, whereby in this class today we are going to look at the cell. So what is the cell? So the cell, this is the basic unit of any living organism. So cell, this is the basic unit of any living organism, is called the cell. So there are two types of cell organisms, whereby the first cell organisms that we have the unicellular organisms, which mainly comprises of an organism comprising of only one cell. So for example, of the unicellular organisms, we have the organisms under kingdom Monera and kingdom Protista or Protoctista. So the other type of organism we have now the multicellular organisms, whereby this comprises of an organism having very many cells inside one large organism. So for the example of the kingdoms under the multicellular part of the organisms, we have kingdom Animalia, we have kingdom Plantae, and some organisms of kingdom Fungi. So we must know that the cells can only be seen by using a microscope. So you can never see a cell by the naked eye or the magnifying glass. You must only see it with the help of the microscope. So what is a microscope, since you have mentioned about the microscope? So simply, microscope, this is an apparatus that is used to magnify the specimen. That's the definition of the microscope. So we have two different types of microscopes, whereby the first type of microscope we have is the light microscope, which is the simplest version of the microscope if we compare it to the next microscope, which is the electron microscope, which mainly magnifies times 500,000 times. So for the light microscope, it only magnifies at about 5,000 times. Let's first of all look at the difference between these two microscopes before we proceed to the next part. So you see that the light microscope, it mainly uses light to illuminate the specimen. So light must bounce through the mirror onto the stage. Whereby the electron microscope, it uses mainly beam of electrons to illuminate the specimen. So for the light microscope, we see that it has very low magnification. But the electron microscope has very high magnification. So for the light microscope, it has a very low resolving power, and for the electron, it has a very high resolving power. So what is resolving power? So resolving power is the ability to be able to distinguish between two very close points. So for the light microscope, the resolving power of the light microscope is very low, and the resolving power for the electron microscope is very high, because for the electron microscope we can zoom at a very large magnitude as compared to the light microscope. So the other difference between the two is that in light microscope the image is mainly observed directly, while in the electron microscope the image is observed using the image is observed on a screen. So for the light microscope, you will observe the image directly from the eyepiece to the stage, while for the electron microscope, you are going to deal with the specimen here, and then you will observe it somewhere else on the screen. So for the light microscope, it uses dead or live or living specimen, while for the electron microscope, the specimen must be dead. It can never use a live specimen to be able to be for the carrying out of experiment, rather. So the specimen in the electron microscope must be dead, while in the light microscope it can use dead or a living specimen. So in the light microscope, the lenses are made of glass, while in the electron microscope, the lenses are made of an electromagnetic material. So in the light microscope, you see that the specimen is placed on the stage, while in the electron microscope, the specimen is placed in vacuum chambers. And that explains why the specimen must be dead, because it is subjected to a vacuum atmosphere. So the light microscope is very cheap, while the electron microscope is very expensive. The light microscope is very common, while the electron microscope is not that common. So let's look at the light microscope parts, because it has different parts that are very much significant in the observation of the specimen. So the first part, we have the eyepiece. So the eyepiece, you see that it mainly contributes to the magnification, and that's the only function. It contributes to the magnification of the specimen. So the next one, we have the body tube, whereby the function of the body tube is to hold the eyepiece and the objective lenses or the revolving nose piece in position. Again, the function of the body tube is to hold the eyepiece lens and the revolving nose piece containing the objective lenses in position. What's the function of the course adjustment knob? The function is to bring up or down the body tube at longer distance to be able to bring the image into a rough focus. So for the course adjustment knob is long distance, then rough focus. So let's look at the fine adjustment knob. So the fine adjustment knob, on the other hand, is that it slightly raises or lowers the body tube to bring the image into a very sharp focus. So for the fine adjustment knob is slightly raises or lowers the body tube to bring the image into sharp focus. So after that we have the revolving nose piece, whereby the revolving nose piece contains different objective lenses and it allows the turning and the changing of different objective lenses that the user wishes to. So what are objective lenses? So the objective lenses, just as the eyepiece lens, the objective lenses, their function is to magnify the specimen. So the next one we have the arm or the limb. At home we have thermos. So we raise our thermoses by holding on the arm. So the function is exactly the same as the microscope. So it's the function of the arm or the limb. So it is used to carry the microscope. And it also supports or holds the body tube in position. So that's the function of the arm or the limb. So the next one we have the stage. So what's the function of the stage? So the function of the stage is that it is where the slide containing the specimen is placed. Remember, I didn't say specimen, but I said this is where the slide containing the specimen is placed on the microscope. So the next one we have the clip, whereby the function of the clip is just to hold the slide in position on the stage. After that, we have the condenser that is located somewhat below, whereby the condenser is just a lens. And what's the function of the condenser lens? The function of condenser lens is to concentrate light on the stage, the light from the mirror onto the stage. We have the diaphragm. What's the function of the diaphragm? The diaphragm regulates the amount of light passing through the condenser to the stage. Or in short, we say the diaphragm regulates the amount of light entering the microscope. So that's the diaphragm. So the next one we have the mirror, whereby the function of the mirror is just to reflect the light. So it captures the light and it bounces it into the microscope. We have the hinge screw. What's the function of the hinge screw? So the hinge screw, it is located between the arm and the base, and the function is that it allows the bending of the microscope. That's it. And then finally you have the base, whereby the function of the base is to support the microscope. So how do you use the microscope? So the first part will say that you should always turn the lower objective lens until it clicks in position. That's the first step. Then the next step will say that you should look through the eyepiece lens to ensure that enough light is passing through. So the next step is that you should place the slide containing the specimen on the stage. And then the next step will say that make sure that the specimen is at the center of field of view that you are observing. After that, use the course adjustment knob to bring the image into rough focus, and then after that, use the fine adjustment knob to bring the image into a sharp focus that you desire. Then lastly, draw and record the observations that you have just made. So how do you take care of the microscope? So you should keep away from edges of the bench. Obviously, you should keep away from the reach of small children. You should always hold the microscope with both hands. Never hold the microscope with one hand. So, in cleaning the lenses, they should only be cleaned by special lens cleaners, not your cloth or not your scarf, but with a special lens cleaner. So make sure that the objective lenses have clicked in position before using the microscope. And then you should always store the microscope in a cool, dry place. So let's now look at how to calculate the magnification of the microscope, whereby we have this formula. Magnification is equal to the diameter of field of view over the total number of cells that you are going to observe. Let's look at an example and say if the diameter of field of view is 5 millimeters and you have counted about 10 cells. So the diameter of field of view is 5 millimeters and you have counted 10 cells. So calculate the size of one cell in micrometers. So the first step, and the always the first step that you should take, is that you should always convert the millimeters to micrometer, whereby you say that 1 millimeter is equals to 1,000 micrometers. After doing that, look at the diameter that you have been given. You have been given the diameter is 5 millimeters. So say that if 1 millimeter is equals to 1,000 micrometers, how about 5 millimeters? So 5 millimeters will be 5,000 micrometers. Now to apply the formula here, we say that 5,000 divided by 10 cells that you have counted, and you are going to get the answer is 500 micrometers. So the size of one cell is 500 micrometers. So let's go to the next one, not the next example, but the next subtopic, whereby we are going to look at the structures of the cells as seen under the light microscope. So we see, first of all, that we have two different types of cells. So the first type of cell, we have the animal cell and we have the plant cell. These cells are totally different. So different organelles can be seen in the animal cell and not in the plant cell, and also in the plant cell and not in the animal cell. But what is an organelle? So if you have been asked to define an organelle, you say that an organelle, so these are the small structures found inside the cell. So that's the organelle. So In the animal cell, we are going only to see the cytoplasm, which surrounds the microscope, the cell rather, to the inside. We are also going to see the nucleus, which is centrally located, and we are also going to see the cell membrane, as you can see in the diagram. So in the plant cell, we are only going to see the cytoplasm and the vacuole, a very large vacuole, as you can see.